These are some mistakes that people make, and they probably do not notice because they keep going back for visa interviews, but already like it's been ruined. So I don't want you to make any of those mistakes, and that is why I'm making this list. Another episode. I am so excited to have you here, and I am glad that the videos I've been making about the US visa process has been helpful to many of you, and that it has even been inspirational to many of you. Many of you have felt motivated to actually study abroad, so that is exciting, and I am very, very excited to welcome the new subscribers and to appreciate the old subscribers for staying and also telling more people about this channel. So thank you. I anticipate more growth, and of course you are going to get more exciting content here. Today I'll be talking about mistakes you should avoid in your visa application process. I'll be pointing out some things that might be subtle but are yet very, very important. Okay, so these are some mistakes that people make, and they probably do not notice because they keep going back for visa interviews, but already like it's been ruined. So I don't want you to make any of those mistakes, and that is why I'm making this list. Number one, please do not lie on your DS-160. Don't be honest. Okay, listen, here's the thing. You might lie, and yeah, some people get away with it, they might not find out, but you know, if you're trying to cram some things that you've put there and then you get to the embassy, you will get nervous. Like, almost everyone gets nervous at the embassy, if not everyone. Okay, you're going to get nervous, and if you're the kind of person that forgets things when they are nervous, then that will be a problem for you. But if what you filled into your DS-160 is true, if the details you've put in there are all true, then there wouldn't be a need to remember what you said. You understand? So please be very honest, be as honest as possible. Okay, two, do not forge bank statements. Please be very careful. If you forge bank statements and they find out, you could get banned for 10 years. Okay, so just try and get a sponsor, and if you do not have someone to sponsor you, then please search for scholarships, search for assistantships if you are going for a graduate program, search for school scholarships, search for scholarships for international students. Some organizations outside the school provide scholarships, so all these things could be piled up to, you know, show that okay, your fees are going to be covered. Some organizations in Nigeria also sponsor students to study abroad. Please look it up. This is why I keep saying Google is your friend. Google is actually your friend. I'm not trying to force you to be friends with Google, but Google is your friend. So please, okay, try and be friends with Google. You don't have to be best friends, but be friends with Google. Number three, do not go into this process with the mindset that it would not work out. You need to be optimistic, okay? And if you're a religious person, be prayerful, okay? Just stay positive. Do not go with the feeling of defeat. Do not go with what you've heard. You know, there are so many stories out there, and some people will tell you, oh, you won't get this because or whatever. Don't be discouraged. Go and see for yourself, okay? Just go and see for yourself. Don't just go based on what people are telling you. Go and see for yourself. Number four, I know we as Nigerians are very secretive, but this process is not something that you should do on your own. Okay, you can carry family members along, you can carry like your best friends along. You need someone that will motivate you, someone that would have additional information for you, someone that would help you out, someone that will pray for you, someone that will assist you in the process. Okay, most times we tend to think that we can do all these things on our own, but we actually need people to support us. So if there's somebody that you trust, even if it's one person, carry the person along. Okay, I know that we have this idea of, oh yeah, I'm gonna do it on my own and then I'm gonna surprise everyone. Sometimes it works out, but the support matters a lot and it's very, very helpful. It's going to help you. Number five, if you're applying to a school, don't just apply without researching the school. You should look up something that makes the school unique. You should look up something that makes you want to go to that school, something about the school that attracts you. Okay, don't just say, oh well, this school has an easy admission and so that's the school I will go to. And then when you get to the embassy and they're asking you, okay, why did you choose this school, you're like, well, it's in a good environment, or oh, because the school is in America and I want to go to America. Those don't make sense. Okay, so if you are choosing a school, please look up what makes the school special and what the school has to offer you, something that the school is offering you that is not exactly being offered by other schools. Okay, so there are so many mistakes that you can make and there's so many mistakes that you might not even be able to avoid, but just try to be very honest and believe in yourself. You are more capable of doing these things than you think. You deserve good things. You deserve to travel the world and experience other cultures. And don't let anyone make you feel like because it doesn't work out for them, it wouldn't work out for you. Okay, I hope that you do not make these mistakes and I wish you good luck in your visa processing journey. Thank you so much for tuning in to today's episode. I hope to see you here again next week. Have a nice weekend and please remember to subscribe, like, share and drop your comments below. If you have questions, you can also drop them below or send me a DM on Instagram, you know, in case you're shy. But don't be shy on my channel though. But anyway, thank you and see you.